this, there are projects that we undertake which may pose some risk to our employees, like when we validate the accomplishments of candidates to the outstanding public officials and employees in the government, we sometimes have to go to far-flung areas to validate their accomplishments. So sometimes in these instances, we may have to also provide hazard pay to our employees. So we support this bill of the Senator. Thank you.
Maraming salamat po. So itong hazard pay is one way of compensating yung mga government employees natin na na-expose sa extreme conditions or dangerous conditions. So ito lang ito. And I believe, for example, BJMP, ano yan, that's that should be considered a hazardous work area. Attorney Ko, please.
Yeah, okay. Your Honor, there is an awkward situation that's happening in the PPA now regarding this payment of hazard pay. Some of our workers, social workers, are paid based on the Magna Carta for social workers. They are paid hazard pay. And those, before we have the clinical services division, which attend to the psychological testing of our clients, they are also given hazard pay. But the rest, they are not given hazard pay. But they are all exposed to this kind of danger because of the Magna Carta. So I was telling the Congress in the lower house before we filed a bill to convert parole probation officers to be given a hazard pay, since they are continuously managing, connecting with these ex-offenders. They are undergoing rehabilitation. So I think that's a very good idea, to give a hazard pay to all, so that it will no longer be an awkward situation wherein some employees in the agency are paid based on the Magna Carta by Congress. Thank you.
Okay, Chief Superintendent Tapayan.
Your Honor, please. under Section 2, we the BJMP, Your Honor, is in full support of this act, Your Honor. But we would like to suggest, Your Honor, that under Section 2, hazard pay sub para E, we would like to suggest that a word jail, comma, prison would be inserted, Your Honor.
Duly noted, Chief Superintendent Tapayan.
Thank you, Your Honor.
So, kasi dahil sa prisons kanila, eh. So, maganda yan. Ipapasok natin. So, ano naman ito? We'll further flesh this out, and we will appreciate all the other inputs. Ngayon, itong ano natin, if you notice, we avoided putting a figure, dahil gusto na natin dito na hindi time-bound yung ating mga legislation. Meaning, kunyari, maglagay kasi tayo ng 1,000 dito. 10 years from now, baka yung 1,000 worth 100 pesos lang. So, we'll need to go through the process again. So, dito, yung DBM nakalagay sa kanila, they have the authority to raise it in the course of time. So, DBM, can we get the position of DBM? Oh. Ano dito yung DBM? Ayaw na nila magpadala ng representative dito sa ano eh. Dahil puro gastos daw yung mga proposals ko. Sige.
DBM has always been supportive of any proposal to increase the compensation of government employees, but we will be submitting an official position paper, DBM position paper on this matter. But let me also, like what Director of the CSC said, there are already existing rules on the payment of hazard should be paid.
Yes, but ang problema kasi when it's not legislated, nagiging flexible to the point na magiging stringent, ano, depende sa ano ninyo.
Sir, kasi yung like what they said, it is different for health workers and for social workers, and then there's also a JAA provision for hazard pay. And then we have a circular on that already.
Mm-hmm.
Opa. Pero we will submit an official DPM position paper consolidating all of this.
Okay. So, ito sa akin, I agree talagang yung mga proposals ko is more basically itong committee natin ay ang trust nito is to give additional compensation. Ang in lieu of actual raising of salaries. Kasi ang ideal pa rin, ako I still believe the only way na improve natin yung bureaucracy is kung improve natin yung sweldo. Hindi yung incremental increases, kundi talagang significant increases. That's what Singapore did, that's what Germany did, and Hong Kong, even as an administrative region, that's what they did when they curbed corruption. Yun ang pangunahing panlaban sa corruption. Kaso dito, maraming resistance kasi gustong i-promote daw, dapat simpleng buhay lang yung mga government employees. Dito, simpleng buhay lang ang gusto natin eh. Pero yung sweldo natin, hindi pang simple eh. Pang below the economic or socio-economic status of the bureaucrat. So gusto natin itaas yun. And I believe all of us would be in agreement pagka nagawa yun, it will cost us money, pero ang resulta naman dyan ay malaking bagay. Kagaya lang nito, si President Duterte pinangakuan ng doubling salary yung mga sundalo at pulis. Sa akin, I'm all for that. In fact, I filed a bill about that. Pero yung DBM, syempre, you have other plans. Kayong kumontra, let's face it, kayong kumontra, di napahiya yung presidente na hindi pwedeng gawin daw. Pwedeng gawin kung gusto. You can do that in tranches, spread 5 years. We already did the math. Kaya natin yan kung gugustuhin natin talagang tanggalin yung corruption sa ating bansa. Okay? Duly noted.
Mr. Chairman, it's good that there's a representative from DBM. I don't know if you were listening to the statements made by Attorney Manuel. I would like to know if DBM was the one who objected na hindi maisama yung binabanggit po ninyo.
Actually, it's not the DBM.
Again, I think i-lay down natin yung premise, no? Pareho yung ginagawa, pareho yung exposure, pero magkaiba yung take-home pay because yung isa hindi binibigyan ng hazard pay. I just wanted to ask kung sino yung nag-object. DBM ba? And the next question would probably be, do we have a study from... I think the word for the day is being proactive. If I'm in the Department of Budget and Management and you talk about hazard pay, I would like to find out saan ba yung mga ahensya ng pamahalaan na talagang hanapin natin. Kanina pinapanggit ni Mr. Chairman and I'd like to associate myself. Hindi dapat subjective eh. Hindi po pwede yung iba mayroong hazard pay, yung ibang wala. So, yun yung mga nais kong itanong.
Yes, okay. Thank you, Your Honor. Actually, yung pumagnapata for social workers, I think this was filed by the BSWD, no? So it's sponsored by the BSWD. So this applies to social workers in government service. So since people are some social workers, they can avail of this. And then during the also the pumagnapata for health workers, they are provisions for hazard pay. So before we have the clinical services division, they are being paid by hazard pay. Now with respect to other provisions and power of doing the same functions, they are not being paid. What's that? It's a question of
dito.
Yeah, sir, kasi yung grant kasi is covered by ano eh, by law. Yes. So iba ho yung rate for the social workers na
defined by law. Siguro yung question ko kanina yung sa DBM, if or on the civil service, if we have a study or you standardize na do you have that? Kasi, for example, ano, I just wanted to share with you, when I was in tech, that I remember, I'm very close to the labor union doon sa loob ng Tesla. And minsan napag-usapan namin, may isang biglang nag-raise. O doon lang, gumawa ang meeting or plano kasi malapit din sa airport. Sabi nila, baka dapat meron din yung outlook day. Medyo, hindi ko naman mahulog din sa upuan ko when I heard that, no? And it's really important na meron talagang standard time na sinusunod, no?
Yung tinatanong niyo po, Senator, kung may study, well, CSC has not done any study of that sort. I don't know with DBM. Pero to a certain extent naman po, lahat tayo is exposed to hazard. The hazards just vary according to the nature, intensity, no? So kung siguro tignan din natin, anong what kind of hazards are really should be compensated?
That's a good initiative, no? To begin with.
Hazard to health. Yes. So we are all exposed to hazards. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
So, siguro what we could do is really try to harmonize and to parang get all the special laws that provide for hazard pay, so we could provide a matrix. Kasi meron din po for S&T workers, for public health workers, and for social welfare. And there's a different one for the military, and then there's one that provided sa general provision sa GAA.
Ang idea natin is makakover yung mga hindi covered. Okay? That's the spirit of the bill that we're proposing. And at the same time, ayaw rin naman natin ma-abuse ito ng mga ina, yung mga piloto po rin, di ba? Walang nabubatin yun sa bureaucracy. So, anyway, this is a pretty straightforward thing. So, we will move forward with this Assistant Director of Planning. Okay, so we look forward to the Technical Working Group meeting. So, meron pa kang mag-oopo dito sa HRP bill? Wala. Okay, Ms. Sanchez.
Yes, good afternoon, Mr. Chair. On behalf of the Leagues of Local Government Units, we would like to express reservations to this bill. Okay. Especially po based on the implementation of the Magna Carta for Health Workers and the Magna Carta for Social Health for Social Workers, hindi po na i-implement actually because there's not enough funds for that. And then giving out hazard pay is also subject to the 45-55% PS limitations. So for the LGUs po, medyo may konti kaming reservations on that.
Okay. Kung sa ganun, Director Urbano, pwede ba natin i-exempt yung mga LGUs? Kasi nga naman, talagang hindi naman sila binibigyan ng additional funds for that. Di ba? Anyway, so pero okay, yun na lang, we can give that to the local government units, yung prerogative to grant kung sino yung kailangan. Pero executive, ano tayo, tuloy tayo.
Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, ma'am. So, with that, we will suspend the consideration on Senate Bill number 503. So, thank you very much for the concerned resource persons who attended. We now move to Senate Bill number 642, or creating a night shift differential pay to the government employees to include those in government-owned and controlled corporations and appropriating funds, therefore. Sige. Okay na kayo. Okay. Maraming salamat. Okay na. Thank you.
Alam niyo kailangan ito ang ipipalagin. Focus lang talaga. Kung malamang kumulang. ako pala di alam. Tatanong. Kilala ako ni Senator pati yung sa kapatid ko sa Commissioner Jara sa Commissioner. Nag-usap ko ngayon palagi sa ganito sa Commissioner. Kasi ko si Senator madami ko po problema. Isa lang itong grabe. Ang pulis namin ay gumagawa pa ka. Hindi po sir, malamis lang.
I am from the IFG. I understand na kausap na po yan.
Ah, oo. Oh.
About the integration of LNG.
Then, ko na lang yung kumakaten. Magpapasadala kayo ng representative sa EWG para yung inputs niya makonsider.
Okay? Sir, friend ko ito.
Best. BSS.
Best friend ko ito na ano, college.
College pa.
Sige pa.
Sige, sir.
Okay.
Okay, for Senate Bill number 642, may we ask Civil Service Commission for their position.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I was just asking our colleague here from the DBM. Kasi po alam ko there are also existing rules on the matter, mm-hmm. And we were checking if this is in the GAA because I understand that they have a DBM circular, and this has been so provided, including the rates and the exceptions. Exceptions section 2. Sorry, Mr. Chair, kasi hindi ko rin po kabisado yung yes. Sanay differential. In fact, we don't have our position paper on this yet. Uh-huh. We need more time to consult with our technical office and DBM. But initially, I think it's just fair that if workers are asked to work on outside of the regular office hours, they should be compensated.
And Sarah, during your was this deliberation, try not to consult with DBM. Automatic, they would look at things differently. Try to look at things from the civil service
perspective. By consultation, Mr. Chair, we mean how is the practice now? What are the problems that they're encountering now? That's what we want. So that will have a clear picture, of a whole picture of the situation. Lahat ba nabibigyan? Bakit hindi nabibigyan? Okay.
So again,
we support. This is worth pursuing in the spirit of fairness. Mm.
Okay.
Yun po. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Well, again, the intention of the bill is to standardize and to cover those not covered, and in the spirit of equality of the distribution of benefits of government. So,
Chair,
yes.
May I be recognized again? On Section 3 provides that the civil service, in coordination with the Department of Budget and Management, may I suggest a rewarding the civil service and the DBM? Kasi madalas naman po on matters such as this, the CSC and the DBM issue joint circular.
Yes, but by wording it as such, or as this, it defines or designates the hierarchy of authority, meaning you are the primary office of primary office of responsibility. Okay, so that's why it is worded as so. Otherwise, kunyari nalagay Civil Service Commission and the Department of kung wala gagalaw sa inyo, wala. Pero dito, kayo yung gagalaw at kakalapitin nyo sila. Ganun po yan.
Okay, we take note of that, okay, Mr. Chair, and we'll relay that to the Commission proper. Thank you.
Salamat po. So, I believe, the essence of the bill is primarily to provide compensation sa mga government workers dun sa mga nasa graveyard shift na tinatawag, night shift, dahil ito mayroong kakaibang effect sa sistema ng tao. Based on studies, talagang na aano sila, naapektuhan sila, hindi sila, they don't live normal lifestyles. That's hence the need for them to be compensated for. So, DBM?
Sir, we already have a circular on this, on night differential.
Mm-hmm.
It's budget circular number 8. It was issued way back 1995, and the rates are basically the same. It's 20% premium for every hour of...
Yes. Ito nga yung sa atin, the essence of the law is the institutionalization of the practice. Otherwise, if it's just a circular, the next DBM would say, tanggalin na natin tong circular na to, alokohan ito. In just a snap, maaangu lahat. Okay, so we need to sort of things in store through a law. DSWD, sir?
In fact, sir, we at the DSWD also has a lot of employees that are working around the clock, 24/7, and definitely we will be benefiting from these developments as proposed in the bill.
So, for the record, you are in support of this bill?
Yes. Yes, sir. We're supporting.
And I may have overlooked your you earlier. Are you also in support of the earlier bill regarding the hazard pay? Just in case some of the DSWD personnel are also qualified for it.
Yes, sir. After hearing the discussions, the provisions that are placed there would also benefit employees, regardless of employment status of the DSWD.
Okay. Maraming salamat po. Sa ano naman, League of... what's the LPP po?
Mr. Chair, League of Provinces of the Philippines.
League
po.
Of Provinces.
Yes po.
Parang ULAP. Ano ba yung ULAP?
ULAP is the umbrella organization of all local government leagues and associations po.
Ah, o nga pala. Sorry. Okay, League of Provinces.
Mr. Chair, we have no objections to the passage of this bill kasi this is also for the general welfare naman po of all government workers.
Provided nyo, di ba?
Availability of funds po. And then if, like so, if DBM will also allow us to lift the 45-55% PS cap.
Which will not happen. Hindi talaga, no?
Sir, kasi it's provided in RA 7160, the PS cap.
So, actually, ano yan, no? It's a challenge. Hopefully, ibang field kasi yon, ma'am, ano? Dito lang ako sa civil service. Pero maraming naririnig ako na reklamo sa about it. And mga solution din. Hopefully, one day, kung mapasok yan sa teritoryo ko, ayusin natin yan. Ngayon, League of Cities.
Yes, Mr. Chair. We do have the same position with the other leagues, with the LPP, Your Honor.
Okay. Sige. So, basically, unanimous tayo ito. However, I recognize that we need to further refine this this bill, so we would invite the resource person so that to a technical working group meeting, which will be set later on, so that we can move forward. So with that, the consideration of Senate Bill Number 642 is hereby suspended. We now move to Senate Bill Number 494, providing government employees to be paid corresponding wages during special holidays. So, civil service again, ma'am. Overlooking GSIS, ma'am, do you have any position about it?
Good afternoon, Mr. Chair. GFIS will be also formally submitting its position paper, but we'd like to inform the committee that GSIS has been paying its employees night shift differential.
So, and Ms. Discartin of
Philippine Government Employees Association, PGA. We support the bill on the overnight the differential pay, and we suggest that in the formulation of its IRR, it will be soon, at least 60 days, because normally the IRR formulation is always delayed, so the implementation of bills like this are always delayed. So we recommend that there should be a time frame in the formulation of its IRR. And we are also willing to join the technical working group.
Salamat po. And just for the record, regarding the hazard pay?
Yeah, we're submitting our, we confirm and we will support those bills.
Salamat po. So, Committee Secretary, please take note that the PGEA should be part of the technical working group meetings of the all the bills that we're tackling today, except this 507. So, with that, okay, we now move to Senate Bill number 494. Ms. Bonifacio, ma'am.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. The CSC will submit its position paper on the bill, but initially we are of the view that the bill is worth pursuing, because right now, casual and contractual employees are enjoying the benefits that are enjoyed by regular employees. May leave, covered by GSIS, and kaya lang pagdating po pala sa compensation, parang may pagkakaiba. No? Casuals are paid on a daily rate, although they receive their pay on a monthly, on the 15th and 30th, pero computed on a daily basis. But I understand yung mga legal, they are paid legal holidays, such as Christmas, Labor Day, but not special working days. The no work, no pay still applies to them. With regard to the contractual employees, monthly rate naman po sila ang pagkakaalam ko, so I think they are paid legal holiday pays, including special non-working days. So, but pinapacheck ko rin po yun sa DBM kung, but that's my understanding of the payment scheme for contractuals. So, the CSC supports this, but we will be submitting our position paper, official position paper on the matter.
Okay. Thank you. Director Aganon.
Same with CSC, we will submit our official position paper. Pero, I'd like to put it on record that casuals and contractual employees are usually paid the same, ma'am. They receive the same form of compensation. Like, they're entitled also to PERA, to mid-year bonus, and the same terms of entitlement, like 4 months
even
of service.
May holiday pay?
I'm not so sure about the holiday pay, but yung contractuals, basically, same as regular.
Then, there should be no problem. Okay, we're just legislating the practice. So, GSIS, ma'am? Wala, hindi kayo ano. PGEA, ma'am? So, your support? Okay. Salamat po. So, with that, we will also schedule Senate DSWD. Yes.
For Senate Bill 494, sir, by and large, we will be submitting our official position, but by and large, we will be supporting the intent of this bill.
Salamat po. Just for the record, ma'am, Ms. Sanchez.
Mr. Chair, on the part of the League of Provinces, we support the passage of this bill. However, we need to make a distinction that these are the personnel, contractual and contractual personnel under the personal services, which is different po, kasi I think we must make a distinction between those job orders and contract of service, which are whose salaries are charged to the MOOE. So kung nasa PS po sila, we have no objection. But I think it's a different ano pag naka-charge sa MOOE.
So talagang ano yung sa inyo, no? Complicated, ano? Nagkakaroon na ba ng opportunity for the League of Provinces o for that matter yung ULAP to confirm with DBM and the DILG para maharmonize ito?
Mr. Chair, the ULAP is starting an initiative of really getting closer to the national agencies, and there are certain issues we're trying to thresh out now with the DBM and the DILG, especially po dun sa mga, if we can say, the certain unfunded mandates, the creation of certain positions. Mm-hmm. So we're working out with the DBM and the DILG. Mm-hmm. So it's still an ongoing process, Mr. Chair.
Okay, so League of Cities?
Yes, we do have the same situation, Mr. Chair. If I may ask, Mr. Chair, there are already many offices created on the ground but could not be filled up due to lack of funds, Mr. Chair. Thank you.
Salamat po. So, with that, I will just be scheduling the technical working group meetings for all of these bills. And I appreciate your attendance. Maraming salamat po. This committee hearing is... Ha? Tema. Excuse me. May isa para. What's this? Ah, okay. We still have one more thing. Consider Senate Bill number 610. I was informed that we have already heard Senate Bill number 610. So we'll just schedule this to another TWG meeting. So maraming salamat po sa ating mga resource persons.
Ito yung agenda natin. Ito another hearing, the rest for TWG. Baka
ma-adjourn. Okay. Just to be clear and for the record, okay, Director Castro.
Mr. Chair, regarding Senate Bill 610, the DSWD, as the Vice Chair for Disaster Response of the National Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council, fully supports the passing of this bill. Mm-hmm. And to further enhance the bill, we would like to clarify whether disaster service volunteer leave will apply to all employees, regardless of employment status. As we all know, not all employees, most of us in the SWD are contract of service workers. And we were hoping that they'll also be included in the provision of this benefit.
Okay. We will definitely take note of that particular input, and we'd appreciate if you join us in the technical working group meeting.
Yes, sir.
So that your interest, or the interest of the people on the ground, especially the SWD, would be incorporated in the bill.
Yes,
okay?
Sir. Okay.
So.
Kasi na-suspended all. Hindi tayo makagawa ng committee report.
So ito na lang muna for hearing.
Consideration or the hearing in as far as Senate Bill number 494, 503, 610, and 642. So all of these bills would be subject to the technical working group meetings at the scheduled date. So only Senate Bill number 507 would be suspended for another hearing. So that is committee hearing is hereby suspended.